first Coverage Over Coffee. So I'd like to thank everyone who has taken time out of their busy schedule to be here today. Also on Facebook, we appreciate y'all. We also have people on GoToMeeting. So we have that information posted on my page if you need the dial-in information, okay? So again, welcome to Coverage Over Coffee. I'm Nicole Ivory. I'm with AI Mutual. We believe that insurance is love. We believe in creating generational wealth. And for those who become clients, you are actually automatically entered into our High Society membership. We'll talk about that a little bit later, okay? But some things that we specialize in, life insurance, which we're going to talk about today, all right? We also specialize in annuities, long-term care, disabilities, business owner plans, plans for those who own businesses, then also will creation, okay? All right. So our agenda for today, we're going to talk about the AI Mutual experience. There's so many insurance companies out there. You know them by name. You're currently with them for your auto, for your home. We're going to talk about why it's important to be with AI Mutual, okay, for your life insurance, all right? Also about myself. Let's get to know me. Why would you want to do business with me? How can I help you? Okay. And then we're going to talk about why life insurance. A lot of people just don't know the importance of life insurance. We are forced to have homeowners policies, right? So even though most people may not understand their homeowners policy, they know they have to have one, right? They know they have to have one. And same thing even with auto insurance. You know, if you don't want to get a ticket or be put in jail, you have to have auto insurance. So unfortunately, life insurance is not something that's mandated by the government. It's just not. Sometimes I feel like it should be because it's like the most important insurance that we should have. Okay. And we'll talk about that today. We'll discover the reasons why you need and should want life insurance. We'll even talk about how to get a policy. Sometimes people think it's really complicated and it scares people away. But we'll talk about what carriers look for, how to get approved, and the insurance process. All right. And then next, of course, we would love for you to schedule an appointment in case we can't answer all the questions today. Today is just definitely an overview. But of course, everybody's needs are specific. So we definitely want to make sure we have that one-on-one appointment for those who are interested. And then I'll supply you with my agency information. All right. Y'all ready?
All right.
Awesome. Yeah. Let's do it. All right. So AI Mutual. I'm Nicole Ivory, an insurance broker. All right. What does an insurance broker mean? It means I actually have the ability to work with many carriers. Okay, I'm not exclusive just to one company. And that's actually a benefit because sometimes when people are just exclusive to one company, they have to just sell those products that may not benefit their clients. So I'm really excited that I represent almost 50, okay, an insurance broker. So I definitely can tailor what I need to do to your personal experience. So I always like to call it an experience. We're hearing this thing called life. Right? Amen. And this is an experience, good, bad, and ugly. It's an experience, right?
Yes.
Our experiences are dictated sometimes by our lifestyle, maybe by our race, right? Maybe by if we're part of a religion, if we're not, you know, what we choose in life, you know, to become. So I'm here to help our life experience be better by having life insurance, okay? I always say life insurance gives you more freedom. When you know that your family is financially protected, it allows you to just live better, okay? You're not constantly stressed. You're not like, oh my God, how are they going to pay for this? So we're here to make sure you have a great insurance experience. But not only that, just from start to finish with the transaction. You'll see today, I have people in the room that can see today I've taken the time out to make sure they have their cupcakes, have their coffee, have the gift bags. You know, I like to just swank it up a little bit. You know, this is just not a sit in front of me at the table. I ask two questions and boom, here's your quote. That's not what I do. I try to get a little bit more personal, okay? What makes us different from traditional insurance companies? Our passion to see our clients succeed, okay? Our success is based off of your success. Our ability to exceed clients' expectations, all right? We incorporate the state-of-the-art technology, which we see today, right? We're here in this beautiful conference room. We also are on GoToMeeting, and we're also on Facebook, social media. So we definitely want to be able to reach you where you are, all right? And then just our involvement in the lives of our clients and local community, okay? And then just talked a little bit about High Society. What is High Society? Well, the HI stands for Happy Insureds, okay? Okay. They are Happy Insureds, all right? So I always like to tell people, welcome to our High Society. You know, it's designed to quench our clients' thirst for financial knowledge and in a fun and informative way. Sometimes people think when you talk about anything financial related, it's so boring, it's going to go over their head. You know, I just like to simplify things, okay? And you're with like-minded people who have like-minded goals for them and their family, all right? So let's get started with the AI Mutual experience. All right, so here I am. And so just to kind of give you a little bit of background about myself, I actually have a strong background in financial services. I've worked for KPMG. I've also worked for PwC. And then my last corporate experience was with MetLife. I actually worked in the national accounts sales team, okay? So they work with the big corporate clients, you know, like, you know, your Cisco or your Southwest Airlines. So we actually insured what we call voluntary work benefits. So if you work for corporate America, you know, once you sign on your first day, they're like, oh, here's your health package. And, you know, here's your, yeah, they have all your disability, your health insurance, all that. So that's what we did. Okay. And, but I was not an account executive, but I was in those meetings like every day. I saw what they did. And so I was like, I could do that, you know? And so also too, just coming from more of an accounting background, switching over to insurance, I needed to ramp up, you know, my knowledge of the insurance. So they were offering free classes, things of that nature. So that actually helped me. And at the same time, I received my licenses and was able to, you know, be a better asset to the team. All right. So from there, I just received all my certifications. And then from there on, I started AI Mutual. Have been doing that for 3 years. So I do have my life and health. Okay, I do have my property and casualty. I also have my adjuster's license. So I kind of do everything in the insurance arena there. All right. And then I'm a notary as well. Okay. All right. Thank you. So why life insurance? Okay, so let's talk about these scary statistics. And I don't want everybody running out, okay? Don't be too scared. But life insurance is very important. Let's look at the statistics. Studies show that as many as 40% of the people that die in the United States, they don't have any life insurance at all. That's 40% of the people, okay? Over 50 million people in the U.S. are underinsured or don't have their own insurance. What do you mean by underinsured? So when you start that new job at your company, they limit you, don't they, of how much insurance you can get. Usually they'll say you can only get, you know, 3 times your salary. Well, that's great if I'm a VP. And maybe not, depending on how much their expenses are in their world. They may not even cover everything they need, right? But they'll say, oh, no, Nicole, you can only have three times your salary, and that's it. Yeah. So that could very well mean that you're underinsured, depending on what you have going on in your life, okay? A lot of other people just don't even own their own insurance. Did you know a lot of companies take out insurances on people, on their employees, but a lot of employees don't even have insurance? Really? So sometimes if you die, a company can get paid on you and your family's still left with nothing. Yep. It's amazing. Yeah. If you're a key employee, they can take out key employee insurance.
Oh.
So that's why I tell people it's best to have private insurance as well, because other people getting paid at the top, like they're already not getting paid, right?
Correct.
But your family is still stuck with nothing. Okay. So let's talk about some other statistics. Since we have African-American people in the room today and a lot of people on social media, let's talk about why life insurance is so needed for us and why we need it to create generational wealth. So in 2010, the median wealth or net worth for Black families was only $4,900. Mm. $4,900.
Nothing.
Right. Compared to the median wealth for whites of $97,000. Okay. Blacks are nearly twice as likely as whites to have zero or negative net worth. Okay. So that's not good. That's not good. Home ownership rate for Black households was 44.9% in 2011, lagging far behind the home ownership rates for whites, which was 73.8%. Okay. Since fewer than half of Black households own homes, this means that the median or typical Black household, there is zero wealth from home equity, okay? So again, we need to make sure we're creating wealth for our future generations, okay?
Absolutely.
So why am I talking about all this and I'm talking about insurance? How does that relate, okay? Let's talk about it, all right? So let's keep going. I just tell people, do not become a statistic. These are the facts. These are the statistics right now. Mm-hmm. Even Andrew Yang, who's running for the Democratic, you know, presidential, he's one of the presidential nominees, he even said by 2053, Black wealth will be zero.
Oh.
Okay. So that means that we're already on a plan for failure. We're already on a plan for failure. Okay. So, right. So we have to individually take charge of our lives. Okay. because clearly the laws and stuff aren't here to help us prosper. Mm-hmm. So we have to individually take charge of our lives. And that's why I'm here to talk about life insurance today. So we'll get to about how it's going to create generational wealth for us. But some other things that life insurance helps us with is it pays for our final expenses. I tell everybody, your funeral is your responsibility. Mm-hmm. Okay, somebody has to pay for that. It's not free anymore. And at one point back in the day, Black people didn't even believe in being cremated. Mm-hmm. Now, all Black people can cremate it because it's cheap. It's cheaper. I should say it's cheap, but it's cheaper, right, than a full funeral and burial. So, and then we're making these decisions based off of economics.
Yes.
Okay. So, and I tell people, you work your whole life, you know, you've done all this for society. I mean, be buried properly, you know? I mean, that's the least you can do for yourself and for your family. There are people I know who have taken out personal loans to bury people. Sometimes death happens in threes. One funeral is expensive. I have one friend who buried four people. That's very expensive. She's still paying on that today. Okay.
But they didn't have insurance.
Exactly. They didn't have insurance, but someone has to take care of that. Right. Mm-hmm. Okay. So I just tell people it's very important. So even if you don't get, you know, sometimes people are single and they're like, oh, I don't need it. You know, I don't have any kids. Okay. We still need enough for final expenses. Okay. To cover your children's educational expenses. So y'all know my daughter. Mm-hmm. She is, I call her Dr. Vanna, right? Or Dr. Diamonds is like what she likes to be called. But she wants to be an obstetrician. I looked that up today and almost spit out my coffee. In order to become an obstetrician today, it's $400,000. Mm-hmm. Okay, she's only six. Mm-hmm. You understand? Right. So in case I die, I need to make sure that I have enough money to cover her college tuition, correct?
Correct.
All right. Again, replace the spouse's income. A lot of people, well, not a lot of people actually are, both spouses are working, right? This is just kind of the economy we're both working in. But even at that, their expenses are at two working adults. So if even if one of them passes away, they're already taking five steps behind, okay? And so let's just say there are households out there where it's just the breadwinner. It's just one person who's working. Well, if that person passes away, they're really 10, 20 steps behind, okay? Because then guess what? The mortgages don't stop. No. Payments don't stop. Car notes don't stop. I mean, you know, okay, they're sorry for you. They may give you 30 days or something. Sometimes people are nice like that, mm-hmm. right? Even and sometimes when they have these economic disasters, you know, people say, oh, well, we'll give you 30 to 90 days because people are understanding. But guess what? It has to pick back up.
Yes.
Okay. It's got to pick back up.
To go.
That's right. And sometimes it takes longer than that, even to find a job sometimes. So, you know, I just tell people, make sure that you have life insurance. Also to pay off debts, again, buy a business partner shares, pay off estate taxes. Okay. And I thought I clicked that off. All right. So let's talk about choosing the correct product. A lot of people don't know what's the correct product. Okay, great. Life insurance is wonderful. Which vehicle should I use to achieve what I need? So I'm definitely a firm believer in term insurance. So is my father, right? We're big on term. If you can get approved for term, I tell everyone needs a term policy. Why do I say that? Because you get more coverage for less money, period. Okay. So it's like, if you're going to pay $100, I'm just saying, if you're going to pay $100 for mine and you can get $1 million policy, why settle for like $100,000 policy? I just don't really understand that. Your family is worth $1 million. You know what I mean? And they can have more leverage and it gives you more options. Okay. So what does that mean? So a term means a level premium. Okay. So for instance, it's going to be over a course of whatever X amount of years. Sometimes you can do 10 years, 15 years, 20, 30 years, right? Usually they don't go too much over 30 years. And then sometimes you can renew those depending on your age. Okay. But pretty much it just means like whatever the rate is that's locked in today, it does not change. That's actually really good because inflation, as y'all have seen, just, oh my God, everything is so expensive now. Like everything is expensive. So it's good to lock that in, especially when you're younger. A lot of people are not thinking about term insurance at all in their 20s. If you can get a, like I do policies for people in their 20s. It is so dirt cheap. I'm like, oh my gosh, you know how much I could be paying? You know what I mean? If I did this in my early 20s. So the younger you are, of course, the lower your premiums are. All right. There's no cash accumulation in your policy, but that's okay. All right. Because you're never going to pay more than what they give you out. Okay. So if you had 30 years, oh yeah, come on in. Come on in. Hey, Thomas. Everybody say, hey. So we just have some more people coming in. But I always tell people, hey, look, go ahead and get that. All right. The next one is return of premiums. I remember I had this one gentleman, he was really cool. He was like, everybody lives long in my family. I was like, okay, that's cool. And so he was just like, he wanted to get the term product that gives him a return of premiums. All right. So basically what he's doing is kind of beating the system, right? Because, you know, they have their morbidity table that says, oh, Nicole, how old are you? You're African-American, you're female. We know, we expect your life expectancy to be X amount of years. Because they're in this thing to make money too. Let's just be honest, okay? But they do have return of premiums available, especially if you know, hey, everyone in my family lives a long time. So this money that I'm putting in, I actually want to get these premiums back. Because with this way, you don't get your premiums back, okay? Mm-hmm. It's kind of like your auto insurance, right? You pay on that every month, or your mortgage insurance. You just pay on that every month in the event something happens. If something happens, then you're covered, right? But they don't give you your mortgage premiums back. They don't give you your auto insurance premiums back. So this is what happens with that. But here, it's a little bit more money, okay? It's a little bit more to have that. But if you know that people have, if you have longevity in your family, it could be worth it to you, okay? This one right here is permanent, or you see over here is whole life. A lot of people are really familiar with this product more, honestly, than term.
Yes.
Okay, because that started off, it's kind of been around a little bit longer. People like the whole cash savings, that vehicle, and that's fine, but if you really research and look at the savings rate, I mean, you can just put your money in a savings account and get the same thing. Plus, you have more control over your money. You don't have to take loans out to get your money. It's easier, easily accessible. So I really do not push permanent products with my clients. If they want it, that's totally fine. I am able to sell it. That's fine, because sometimes people, that's just what they want. You know, this is your life. However, the reason why I don't is because you're generally paying more for less coverage. So for me, I just feel like I'm doing a disservice to you when I know I can give you more for less. It just makes sense to me. So I like to save money. You know, I'm always looking for a discount, especially if I can get, you know, the Gucci brands right at the discount prices. So I just, that's why I'm just not really big on permanent products. Okay. All right. So let's talk about how do we get a life policy? What are the steps? Okay. What do carriers look for? Insurance companies look for the below items when they're trying to insure an applicant. They're looking for a steady paycheck. I put that number one. Okay. Because a lot of people may want it, but if you don't have a job or you don't have any income coming in, like that's automatically disqualified. Okay. They ask you, where do you work for? You know, who do you work for? Do they want to know your company name, how long you've been there, what your salary is? Okay. Health record. The MIB report or Medical Information Bureau. This is kind of like a high level medical search. Okay. They're not digging into, you know, 10, 15 years of medical research here. They just want to see, okay, let's check out Nicole. Like, you know, does she have anything that may cause a red flag that's life threatening? Right. And so that's what they look at here. All right. And then I even say some insurance carriers even do a soft pull on your credit. Okay. Some of them do. A soft pull means it's not going to be a hard inquiry. So if you look up something on Credit Karma or whatever, it's not going to show up on there, but they're doing a soft pull because they want to make sure like you're not being shady, right? Like you have, you're so far in the hole or you're trying to put a policy on someone and kill them, right? Because you need to pay off all this stuff going on over here. You should be amazed how much people are in debt. Okay. So they have to look at that. All right. But they do a soft pull. So it's not going to affect you if you're trying to get a house or anything like that. Also, RX report. So this is going to be for your pharmacy. Okay. This is your medicine history. Again, they're looking at those medicines, the medication, see what's in there, see if there's anything in there, right, that could be a red flag. All right. And then this one right here, I just put this out. Okay. Honesty. They're looking for honesty on these applications. Yes. Really, they know more about us than we know about ourselves. They really do. It's so much. It's crazy. Like something just happened the other day when we had a blue alert and they were wanting us to, did y'all get that on your cell phone when it was going off? Blue alert.
Amber alert.
Oh no, a blue alert. Yes, it's totally new. So basically if I guess if someone, yeah, if the link didn't even work, right? But I guess if someone commits a crime against a police officer or law enforcement, then they want you to be aware of this individual. So I guess you can turn them in. But I was like, quit wasting my time. Okay. The government has access to everything. They can track us. We have RFID chips. Cameras are probably looking at this presentation right now. Mm-hmm. I'm kind of like, you don't need me to help you do your job. My taxes pay you, right? Mm-hmm. So I'm just trying to say they're looking for honesty because these people know more about us than we know about ourselves. One thing that's very interesting, too, we know they've always done this, but it was kind of like under the table, you know? But now, so the state of New York, which kind of sets the precedence for all other states in insurance, they now have the okay to be able to see if what you have put in your application is true. So if you're like, oh, I'm healthy, I'm this and eating all crazy, or you bungee jumping, and, you know, they're looking at all that now. And you're like, why did my application get denied? You know, because they're looking at that. And they've always looked at it. Don't get it twisted, right? But they don't admit it. Now, state of New York can openly say this is why we're denying you. And other states are starting to consider that now as well. So one thing I want to tell everybody, and I posted this up on my Facebook company page, AI Mutual. So not everyone who is a part of that yet. But you know how they have those 10-year challenges? Be careful with that. That's a scam. Because they want to see how you're changing. If you look bad, they're going to be like, oh, no, something's going on. You know, but if you look great, if they see that you're losing weight, you look healthy and all this, they're like, oh, okay, that's insurable. They got to make sure you're insurable. Look, they're in the business to make money. Okay? They want to make sure you're not going to die tomorrow. This is what it is. Okay? So I'm just saying it's interesting how sometimes they put these challenges out here and we just think it's all fun and games, but really there's a business element to that. Okay? It's very interesting. Exactly. It's very interesting. Mm-hmm. So how to get approved. Again, the policy amount should reflect your lifestyle. Now you can. You know, if you have enough money to, you know, buy a $3 million policy, you can do it. They're going to ask questions. You know, if you're only making $50,000, right, they're going to ask questions. Just best believe it. But I can't, I'm not going to say you're not going to get approved for that. Okay. Because you can. But they just want to make sure that your current income kind of reflects your lifestyle. And that makes sense. Like how I just said, oh, my daughter, she's going to be obstetrician and costs. They just want to make sure you can talk it through with them. Okay. Your current income can support your premium. Okay. Again, a health history. You know, they're taking a health exam, you know, in the last year, it drastically increases your chances of approval. Why does that happen? Why is that? Because they're like, hey, look, you're interested in your health, especially with men, because men really don't go to the hospital. Mm-hmm. And they have to pull your records, your health records. Okay. So the more recent they are, the better data that they have. If they find something from 5 years ago, or they only have one time that you ever went in your life, they're quick to deny you because they feel like you're not that interested in your health. There could be other things going on that they don't know about. So like I have one person right now, it's pretty awesome. You know, he has diabetes. He was like, oh no, everything's going well. They're about to take me off this medication. I was like, great. When are you about to go to the hospital? When are you going to go for your checkup again? In January. That's fantastic. We're going to wait until he goes for his checkup in January, where they pull him off that medication. His weight has dropped, everything, you know, blood pressure, all that, because now you are more insurable. Yes. So there's a strategy. It's a strategy. So that's why I say, I just don't just sit in front of people 2 seconds, you know, it's a strategy. Okay. So I want to make sure that you're winning. All right. Lastly, the insurance process. Okay. Let's talk about the process. It can be as short with my company is less than like maybe 10 days. And it can be longer just depending on what we need. So, of course, submit the application. We do a lot of things online nowadays, okay? So,
everything.
Yes, everything's done online. Yes, so, everything. So please don't have me do any paperwork. So, it's just tedious. But anyway, I can submit. If you want me to do it, that's totally fine. So, one thing that's pretty cool is, like, you can literally be in the comfort of your home or wherever you are on a cruise. Thomas, you could be on a cruise just sitting back, right? And actually go to my webpage. And actually submit online. Okay. You can, you don't need me to do that. Right now, of course, once I get that, cause it will give me a notification because there are people who do that. It sends me a notification. Then I personally call them right to go everything. And I still do my entire presentation with them. Okay. Cause I want to know who I'm dealing with here. Right. But I'm just saying you can do that yourself. Now, now another thing I was going to say too is, or if you would like, when I have my meetings one-on-one, I go through that. Okay. But at the end of the day, it's still going to be done online. All right. And I like that because once it goes through, you receive a notification. It's a project management tool. Okay. It keeps everybody on board. Right. Everybody has documentation of what was submitted. There's no questions. It just kind of cuts out all of the problems that could happen. Okay. Tele-interview. This is usually a 30-minute phone call. All right. So normally I prefer to submit applications where my insureds do not have to do any medical testing, okay? You can have that option, usually pay $1 or $2 more per month, you know, to be able to skip the medical testing. I try to do that all the time. Let's speed it up, let's get it in. Why do medical testing? You don't have to, right? Now, okay, there we go. Now, sometimes, you know, again, depending what's pulled, it may be a red flag to where they have to do medical testing. And that's why I put medical screening in person. Okay, they can actually come to you, to your home. And it, again, it doesn't even last long. I mean, maybe 30 minutes, depending who you deal with. Now, you get some people who like to chat. No, that's totally fine. And you, it can take an hour, okay? Because some of them chatting, Kathy. But basically, they just want to verify your weight, right? They take your blood, right? They're doing all these samples. They can find everything in the blood, right? It's amazing. And urine samples, right? And that's it. You know, Thomas, you know. So it's like, and that's it. That's pretty much it, right? And then they send that off to get tested. And then once everything has been received, then comes the underwriting review. Usually that takes the longest, right? And before then, let's just kind of go back up a little bit too. So let's just say, for instance, they do find something in your medical history that's a red flag. They may have to have you pull reports, okay, from your medical history that they need from your doctors, okay? For me, that usually takes the longest time. Because every medical office is so different. Some people have a system, some people don't. Some people have good employees, some people don't. You know what I mean? And so I can't help in that process because I don't have access. Okay, so that part is kind of on my clients and their doctors to be able to get that information to whichever carrier is requesting it, okay? But that's where pretty much I always say, like, it could be the longest. But then anyways, after underwriting review happens, the approval, the initial premiums pay, you have to pay that first payment, okay? So let's just say it's $50 every month. You have to pay that first payment of $50, and it's always with a checking account, or excuse me, always with a bank account, if you can check it or savings, okay? A lot of carriers, Gerber, they're okay with the credit card, but most carriers, no credit cards, okay? And it can't be a prepaid card. It has to be a checking or a savings account from a credit union or from a local bank, all right? And then once that payment is made, then your policy is enforced. Most people now do e-policies, so they send it directly to your email account, okay? Awesome. And then again here, once you're insured, now this is always the best part, so keep your policy active, okay? They can't pay you if the policy's not active, all right? I've had a lady call me. She wasn't a client. She was just like wanting to get insurance. Like after the fact, and I'm like, it doesn't really work like that. But a lot of people just kind of don't know, you know, it doesn't work like that. So you have to make sure you keep the policy active, pay premiums on time. Okay. Usually you have a 30-day grace period. So I tell, you know, my insurance, you know, during my process that if something does come up, let me know. Okay. Because as long as communication, it's just communication. People know things come up. So as long as I'm letting them know, or if you need to switch your date or switch your billing cycles or however it goes, just let me know, and I'm happy to get that done for you, okay? And then also say inform your primary and contingent beneficiaries about the policy. There's nothing worse than having an active policy, and then your beneficiaries don't even know about it. So you pass away, and they're like, oh, I'm sure, you know, daddy or mom had a policy somewhere. And you have no clue, you know, how many insurance companies are out there?
Mm-hmm.
And how they switch names and how they're bought out. And, I mean, it's just ridiculous. You know how much... you know, stuff is in people's houses just trying to find this. It's just crazy. So I just tell people, hey, look, you know, once you get your policy, I mean, at least give them the name and the policy number and the amount. That's like three things you can just do.
I had family. Let me cut you off.
No,
I had
family
that went through that where they couldn't find the insurance policy nowhere.
Yeah.
And then when they did find the insurance policy, it was expired.
Wow.
They didn't have a beneficiary.
Oh no, and they didn't have a beneficiary listing.
But then they finally found the insurance policy. They couldn't get in contact with the people because they changed their name, changed their phone numbers. So it was chaotic.
That's too much. And I said that's unnecessary. You're already stressed, you're already sad, you're already grieving.
You're already grieving.
I mean, it's ridiculous. We still have your own personal life you're doing. People still gotta go to work, still take care of their own families. Mm-hmm. That's a lot, you know. So let's just make it easy for people that we love when we leave. In the event we leave, you know? Maybe here after them, I'm just saying anything you leave, just make it easy for them, okay? Let them know where to locate us. Send them an email. I mean, you know, text. I mean, it's just easy now, you know. There's no excuse. And then just update your will with your policy information. I like to have that included in there. So that way there's no question. You already know you have all your documents just one place. Okay. And if it changes, just update it. Okay. Awesome.
My mom tells me that every time we talk, she get on that kick about if she goes before me.
Mm-hmm.
Cause it's just me and my brother.
Yeah.
Sonya, everything is in this top corner over here and the left hand side and the brown
envelope. That's good.
My mom don't want to hear that right now. But I'm glad that she keeps my mind on it. When that time comes, I don't have to be scrambling and looking.
And that's right. That's love, actually, right there. Mm-hmm. Being prepared. I said it's nothing better than being prepared. She's being proactive.
Mm-hmm. And my dad saying the key for mine is hanging on the back there. Okay. He keeps his in the lockbox.
Okay.
Because his health is a little worse than my mom because he has stents.
Okay.
He had several heart attacks, strokes. So his heart is not strong like it used to be.
Mm-hmm.
So he reminds me every day I see him.
Okay.
He said, you never know.
You never know. Exactly.
So I try to tune that out. But it's good that you have
those communications. And I think sometimes it's hard for us to have that communication. Mm-hmm. Especially African-American community. We just feel like we're going to live forever. Superheroes, we're immortal. I don't know. But we have to have those communications. You know, it's just a part of love. It doesn't mean anybody wants you dead tomorrow. You know, it's just crazy what people think that means. But even sometimes when I talk to people about it, it's just, you can tell there's a little friction sometimes with their family. You know, it's uncomfortable. Talking about death is uncomfortable. However, in the African American community, we have to get past that. Because as you just saw, we are struggling. We are struggling on paper. So we have to get past that just to make sure that we're okay. All right.
I think the reason why we struggle is because a lot of us don't know the beauty that comes with dying.
Yes.
And if they're not properly taught the purpose of death, then they are going to be afraid of
it. That's true.
Like a lot of people don't know the difference of living and dying.
Mm-hmm.
And they look at death as a bad thing.
Mm-hmm.
But if they're properly taught spiritually.
Yep. Oh, we're about to get into it. We got all religious people up in here.
They understand the meaning of why to be prepared.
It's not the end.
But you can help make the transition smoother.
Exactly. I say on this life and our next life, let's just make it easy, right? And plus, you're setting a great example for those who are living. I always tell people, yes, I do push financial legacy, but we're talking about spiritual legacy as well. But having your house in order, period. The Bible talks about that.
Yes.
Talks about that. And so, you know, we're supposed to leave wealth to future generations. So I think sometimes... And we have a lot of people who are spiritual hero as well on our social media. I think sometimes we just kind of skip over that. We just think, you know, we don't really stress enough of that in the church. You know what I mean? But we have to start living a spiritual, financial legacy as well for our families. Okay.
And some look at death as a material gain.
Right.
They don't look at it as a beneficial for the whole family. They just look at the material things that are left behind in death.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes our material things are taken away because it's not properly noted on what to do with the material things.
Well, let's talk about that too. And this is totally separate, but I know even with just land, and we're about to wrap up here, but even with land, Black, you know, once we received our freedoms, Blacks were given land, you know, and it's been taken away from us. Strategically, because we don't put anything in writing. So the laws know that. So they say, hey, look, sorry, if you don't have a will, if you haven't shown anything in paper, showing it's going to be passed down. They have taken that. So you have to make sure everything is documented. I always make sure, you know, I have people all the time, you know, constantly updating their beneficiaries and contingent beneficiaries. That's fine. As long as everybody knows, you know what I mean? And it's updated. You know, I just say, as soon as you want to do something, let's get it done. Because what we do is we're procrastinators, aren't we? It's almost 2020. Some people have gone a whole nother year without life insurance. That's my goal today, is just to make sure we don't put off tomorrow what we can do today. Because again, like I said, we don't want to be this one lady coming after the fact wanting help. Because we've seen it all the time on social media with these don't get me started. And I'm going to wrap this up so I don't get so upset, right? But but we just saw how the UPS driver in Florida was killed on his first day on the job. And guess who did not pay for his funeral? UPS. And that's a major company. They have billions of dollars. They actually set up a GoFundMe account, which lets me know his family didn't have insurance. You understand? And so I'm just kind of like, we have to start taking care of ourselves, be responsible for ourselves, because no one else is responsible for you.
Some things are
even if it's, you know, nice to do. Like, I think that would have been a good thing for them to do in the end of the year, holiday time, showing their employees that they care. They didn't even take that opportunity to do that. Isn't that sad? So anyways, I just want to wrap up and just again, thank everybody for coming out. But then also too, again, we have our online, you know, life rate simulator that I was telling you guys about that you could do on your cruise. And again, it has wonderful A-rated carriers that only work with the best. Okay. So like principal, MetLife, AIG, Prudential. And then these are our offices. So of course, in Waco, this is my spot here. I love it. It's a co-sharing spot. So mm-hmm. if you want to, you can take a tour around. But then also in Dallas, we have other co-sharing offices as well. So if you know anyone in those areas, I'm happy to meet with them too. Okay. And then this is my contact information. I put some information in your goodie bags. Feel free to reach out.